Office 365 is a subscription service of our Exchange, SharePoint, and Link server applications, as well as our client applications, Office Web Access clients. And so it provides a cloud-based capability to use all of our servers as a single low-price subscription. One of the key design elements that we have in Office 365 across all the products is really a change from trying to solve problems by figuring out what failed, and instead moving to an operation model that says we need to return the customer and the service to service availability at all times. One of the key design principles that we've worked through is to ensure that every region we have multiple locations or multiple data centers. These data centers are distributed geographically in that region, and we ensure that those two centers are synced relative to customer data. As a result, we're able to do two things. One is maintain the data within a given geography so that we're not whizzing data across the world. The second thing is we're able to keep those elements in sync in such a way that we can fail over from them almost transparently with customers. Further, we actually test this on a regular basis. On a monthly basis, we actually do production tests where we fail over from site to site. And we actually, and that kind of a test basically rebuilds and builds upon the capability to improve our ability to basically return to operation in the event of a service failure. Compliance is a key aspect of the service. We want to actually ensure that we can provide the customers the necessary controls around privacy, security, and access so that they can look at our service and understand if through using it, they can meet their obligations. One of the key ways we do this is via the Trust Center. The Trust Center is a site on Microsoft's properties that represents where our customer, where we maintain customer data, how we deal with compliance efforts, what certifications we have, and what attestations we do. And so it's a single place where customers can see our commitment for trustworthy computing, privacy, security, and compliance. Our principles of privacy are pretty straightforward, which is really that the customer and the individual own that data. And so the obligation is for us to be able to operate that infrastructure without us accessing customer-created content. How do we operate the service without having admin access to every aspect of the service? By building in functionality into the product, into the UI, where the customer controls what happens to the service relative to a functionality standpoint. And so if they have key attributes or policies they want to apply, they do that without having to engage us. The second approach we do is through what I'd call our central admin or automation approach, which is really to actually take a development approach to managing the system so that we check in code into a controlled script database, and then that code is controlled through automation around approval. And so what happens is you submit a request to make a change, and somebody approves that change. And the result is there isn't standing permissions to do a task. It's the service managing the service through people submitting requests. We do actually provide service level agreements to our enterprise customers. This is a financially backed guarantee where we're saying we'll achieve the following service level, and if we fail, we'll pay you back. That payback is actually in service credits or real dollars based on how they're engaged with the service.